Okay, it's Colonel Serene, and I'm trying to get this music to play for you.
What we've got here is failure to communicate. Some men you just can't reach. So you get what we had here last week, which is the way he wants. Well, he is.
Okay, so the song is Guns N' Roses Civil War, and the strange stories of the Civil War, the U.S. Civil War, have got so much to do with the Masonic conspiracy. Why is it a conspiracy? Well, like anything that's hidden, I guess, is a conspiracy. It might not even be a conspiracy, but, you know, that's what people call these kind of things, these big questions. But down in the South, one of the generals of the Confederate Army was a Master Mason teacher. And the story goes that at one point he crossed the lines between the North and the South during the war and went into the North in order to teach or give a speech in the North. So how can it be, if you're in the middle of a war, that you would allow an enemy general to come and lecture? It sounds kooky, doesn't it? But that is the story, and what does it really tell you? Was the Civil War completely phony baloney, as if it never happened? Why do I say that? Because history is always written by the victors. And we all know about fake news. Nobody really talks too much about fake history, but if there's fake news, why isn't there fake history? Which may mean, you know, family histories that go back hundreds of years, are they doctored? Are there people lying? I'm not so sure I would go that far, but what I would give you is the multiverse and multiple kinds of timelines. Perhaps in one timeline there was a civil war in the United States. Perhaps in another timeline the civil war never happened. The multiverse. Or you'll have to come up for an explanation of why they would send the Master Mason teacher through enemy lines to go and allow him to lecture in the North during the middle of the war. Well, if you look at Washington, D.C., the history of it, it's full of Masonic symbolism. And there have been Masonic conspiracies. In Wikipedia, I've looked them up in the United States, where certain Masons turned on the organization and told their secrets because there was a lot of abuse of power. And that's not to say that's the only group around that's involved. I mean, we hear the stories about the satanic Luciferians in Hollywood and other places, foreign countries with their spy networks, great secrets constantly being told about, off-world extraterrestrials, perhaps, and then the timelines where things happen and other timelines where they don't. What timeline are we in now? I don't think it's that important what timeline we're in now, because the thing about timelines is that you, as an individual, can shift from one timeline to another. Perhaps you like to go to different timelines to see what history might have been like in different timelines, if you're a time traveler and a multiverse traveler. Or maybe you were born into a shitty timeline, like Colonel Serene, and you're looking to jump into what I call the divine timeline, where, you know, the old idea of bringing heaven to earth in the divine timeline. You, if you're in a shitty timeline, you jump to the divine timeline and you see heaven appear right here on earth. I hope you enjoy my lectures. I also want to bring it to your attention about anomalies. You can use Wikipedia and look up some information like I did. Look up the history of shipbuilding around World War II in the United States. You can use other things besides Wikipedia. But when I looked in the timeline, when I looked, and this was several months ago, there weren't enough shipyards to build the number of ships that are said to have been built during World War II for the U.S. Navy. There weren't enough shipyards, and the shipyards that were very inexperienced and didn't have a lot of labor. World War II ran from 1939 to 1945, and if you look at the vast amount of ships that were built during that time, and the infrastructure to build them, no, they couldn't be done that way. So something is being lied to us. Either they had more shipyards, hidden shipyards, or World War II never happened and it was a phony baloney, fake war, fake history. Personally, I wasn't around during World War II, but I had testimony of others that said it happened. Timelines, different timelines, or the whole idea of the multiverse is wrong and it's misinformation and these wars did or did not happen. But the facts don't match. The number of shipyards and the number of U.S. Navy ships in World War II and the speed at which they claim these ships were built, it doesn't match. So there is something hinky with the story of World War II. There was some other piece that just recently came out about nuclear weapons and the films that were made of nuclear weapons being faked. Fake Hollywood inventing nuclear blasts and the effects of nuclear blasts being faked. What does it all mean? I am out of time. I will ask you to go and research it if it resonates with you. See what you get, and maybe the mystery for you will make you go, what the hell is going on? I'm Colonel Cliff Serene, and that is your daily update.